Welcome to this ePMXpress tutorial. Using Internet Explorer, go to the address shown here to access the EPM portal. There will also be a link at the end of this tutorial. To access the ePMXpress application, click on the option labeled ePMXpress. When outside of the GSA network, multi-factor authentication is required. With your GSA user ID entered, click Submit to continue to the next step. Select the delivery method for your temporary registration code and click Submit. With your 4-digit registration code entered, click Submit to continue to the next step. The final step of MFA requires your Active Directory password. If you have forgotten your password, you can click on Forget Password in the lower left. Click Submit to continue. Creating a new project. To create a new project, click Create New Project in the top left corner of the screen. Select the appropriate EPM program based on region and program. Select a project template. Contact your RSA for more information about templates. Populate required fields highlighted in yellow. Optionally, populate additional project details as needed. In the Project Team section, click Add Line. In the search field, type the name of the GSA Project Manager and click Find. Click on the GSA PM's name highlighted in the list to continue. Select Key PM GSA Project Manager as the project role. Select Project Access as appropriate. Optionally, add additional project team members, milestone schedule information, and funding as needed. Click the Save button in the toolbar to complete project creation. Opening an existing project. To open an existing project, click on the appropriate Level 1 grouping to expand Level 2 in the left menu. Click on the appropriate Level 2 grouping to display available projects. Click on the appropriate project to open that project. To change how projects are grouped and displayed in the left menu, you can click on the My Preferences icon highlighted in the top right of the screen. Editing project details. With the appropriate project open and the Project Detail tab selected, click Edit in the toolbar to edit the project details. Edit fields as required. Click Save in the toolbar to save your changes. Editing the project team. With the appropriate project open and the Project Detail tab selected, click Edit in the toolbar to edit the project team. In the Project Team section, click Add Line. In the search field, type the name of the project team member and click Find. Click on the appropriate name in the list. Select the appropriate role from the project role list and select Project Access as appropriate. Click Save in the toolbar to save your changes. Editing the project schedule. With the appropriate project open and the Schedule tab selected, click Edit in the toolbar to edit the project schedule. To add a milestone, click Add Milestone and enter a description in the Activity column. To remove a milestone, select a milestone by checking the box to the left of the activity, then clicking Delete Milestone. Enter an estimated date for each milestone. To baseline a milestone, select the milestone by checking the box to the left of the activity, then clicking Baseline. All milestones can be selected by checking the box in the header. Enter actual dates for each milestone as they are completed. If the project has multiple customers and the milestone only impacts one of those customers, select the appropriate customer from the list next to that milestone. To add notes about a milestone, click on the pencil icon to the right of that milestone. Enter notes and click OK. Optionally, users can manage their schedules in a Gantt view by clicking on Launch EPM Schedule in the toolbar. Click Save in the toolbar to save your changes. Entering PM financials. With the appropriate project open and the PM Financials tab selected, click New Funding in the toolbar. Populate required fields as highlighted and additional fields as needed. Then click Save to continue. Repeat these steps as needed to record all funding sources. Each funding source will be displayed in a separate column on the PM Financials tab. Click New Estimate in the toolbar. Populate required fields as highlighted and additional fields as needed. Then click Save to continue. Repeat the steps as needed to record a history of all estimates on the project. To review the estimate history, click on the Estimate History button above your current estimate amount. Click New Contract in the toolbar. Populate required fields as highlighted and additional fields as needed. Then click Save to continue. Repeat these steps as needed to record all contracts on the project. Contracts will be displayed in rows on the PM Financials tab. Once a contract has been created, modifications can be recorded by clicking Add Modification under the appropriate contract. Invoices can be recorded against a contract by clicking Add Invoice. Entering monthly project updates. Per central office guidance, the following monthly updates are required for a project in ePMXpress. Regional and customer-specific requirements are not addressed in this tutorial. The first requirement is project status. To record a new project status, navigate to the Project Details tab and click Edit in the toolbar. Click the Add Status button below the Project Status field. Populate the As of Date field in the Project Status Memo field, then click Save in the toolbar. To review the project status history, click View History below the Project Status field. The next required update is to verify the project schedule. Navigate to the Schedule tab, review the schedule data, and if correct, click the Verified button in the toolbar. Finally, the PM Financials must be verified. Navigate to the PM Financials tab and review the financial data. If correct, click the Verified button in the toolbar.